Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And someone asked me recently, Patrick, you're talking so much about serverless. What if I want to use SQL authentication to connect to my serverless? Can you do that? I was like, I think so, but let me go do some tinkering. Stay tuned to find out how I solve this problem. Find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, before I get into this, I want to give a big shout out to Brad Shat. He spent about 30 minutes with me figuring this out, okay? Because it wasn't as easy as I thought. If I think about, you know, SQL Server, it's easy. You create a login, you create a user, you give them access. When you're using serverless, it's a little more involved, and I want to show you, okay? Let me say this. If you're using Azure Active Directory authentication, it's really easy if you go that route. But if you want to use SQL authentication for your serverless pool, then it's a little more involved. And that's what I'm going to show in this video. All right. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. We started here, and I'll make sure that it's a link in the comments below. But this doc was critical. And in this section for database scope credentials, it gives you the different methods that you can use to set up this database scope credential. This will make more sense as I go through the demo. But notice the first thing I want to show you is that if you're using Azure AD Identity, you just can give them access to the storage instead of doing all the stuff we're about to do. It provides a sample for each one. In my case, I'm going to use a managed identity. So let me show you how we went about doing this. So the very first thing is you need to go create your serverless database. So I went out to my Synapse Studio and click on data. And then you click right here, this little plus to add a resource. And you'll see where it says SQL database and you choose serverless. And you create your database. Once I created my database, I have a couple of databases in here. This is one I'm going to be using for the video. I created some views. And when I initially created these views and I tried to connect with my SQL account, bam, didn't work. There's some more steps. You can use Synapse Studio. You can use Azure Data Studio. I'm using Management Studio here. What you do is in the context of that database, you would create my master key, give it a password, then you create your database scope credential. You can actually create this at the server level. I'm doing it at the database level because I want to really focus in on what I'm giving people access to. And then once you create that managed identity, you're going to create an external data source. And you can see the path to my data source is Azure Blob File Storage. And you can go here and then it's the name of the container that contains the files that we're going to query and then the name of your storage account. And then you must specify the credential, which is this credential that you create. The thing I want to point out here is the container name. It must be lowercase. Okay. It is case sensitive. I had it as caps and it wasn't working. Brad was like, just change the lowercase. We changed the lowercase and that solved our problem. Once you do that, then it's just regular SQL Server stuff at that point. You create a login, you create a user, you can give that person full access to read all the objects, or you can get a little granular and say grant select on each individual item. And then you need to also either give that user control over the server, or you grant references on credential. Either one would work, but you need to follow these steps. And I'll make sure there's a link to this entire script in the comments below. Once you do that, then you create your views. And when you create your views, you must specify the data source as one of the open row set parameters, because that's how it's going to access the storage. So you can see I'm going to my product dimension here with that credential, and then I'm going to my fact sales here with the same credential. So you need to do that. If you don't, you're going to get a nasty little error when you're using some client tool like Power BI or Excel or even Management Studio. When you try to query those views, you'll get a, hey, I don't have access to this credential, or it doesn't exist. So you need to make sure you follow these steps. All right. Once you do that, then you head over to the portal and you see right here where it says serverless SQL endpoint, copy that. And then I'll go over to Power BI. You guys know I love Power BI, but any tool that can connect to SQL Server. So you see right there, I'm going to choose SQL Server. I'm going to put the server name in. And then I'm going to click OK. It'll go out. It's going to say, how do you want to connect? Again, if you have Azure Active Directory, you know, that's great. Go ahead and use Azure Active Directory. It could save you a few steps. But for me, I'm going to use a SQL account. See if I can get my password right on the first one. That's why I put it on Notepad and choose connect. There we go. Once we connect, you can see my sales. I expand it. There's the two views. I click it, it gives me a preview of the data. It takes a little bit to query, boom, and then I can click load. Once I click load, it'll go back to the source. It's actually querying the Parquet files, which is brilliant with this serverless. It's amazing to me. All right, what do you guys think? Have you tried to connect to serverless using the SQL account? Did you run into challenges? Did it help? Did this help? You do it a different way? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button, like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Whew.